I think we're getting closer.
John, do you have views?
Oh. I was going to defer to Jerry here, actually.
Very good question, and I think that this is, like Judy has mentioned, I think that this is our hope of the blood working group. You know, we started with the blood primarily because of the transmission and the risk to the blood supply, but I think through the blood working group, we're going to gain a lot of experience, and I think that we're going to come out with the standardization of some of the methodologies, just as Graham presented today about the sample preparation. We don't have all the data to show you and to share with you, but at least we're trying to standardize even with the sample preparation and the time to processing, and just that alone may help us. But there's a lot that we can do, and I think that through this blood working group, we can standardize some things.
You have to bear in mind, it's been less than a year since people, most of us, have been seriously thinking about dealing with these issues. It's really quite a short time. It takes a long time to set, for example, to set up the blood working group panel. It was probably 6 months of talking and deciding and so on before we even began to get samples really in. It's only been a couple of months that we've been working on that. So I'm quite optimistic that, say, within the next year, there will be a synthesis of this to the point where not necessarily everybody's using exactly the same assay. You don't do that with HIV. You use different assays, but you have different assays designed for different purposes in HIV infection. And I think we'll head toward that fairly quickly now, I would predict. But right now, we're still in kind of a zone of chaos where, since we don't have agreement on almost anything in this, we have to work toward that right now. But I'm optimistic we'll get there soon.
So I make a bounce for this. John Mellers, Chief of Infectious Disease, University of Pittsburgh, and I'm a virologist. I make a bounce for this because it's more of a statement than a question. But I am struck, and I'll restrict this to chronic fatigue syndrome, I'm struck by the highly divergent prevalence of detection of anything among cohorts with CFS. And it's really very striking sitting here in a day and a half, from 0% to as high as 70, 80%. Part of the problem could be different patients are being studied. Part of the problem could be different detection methods. I propose a simple way to add clarity, and that is the same patients be tested by multiple laboratories. The blood working group has started this, but their primary concern is the safety of the blood supply. This leaves patients with the syndrome and healthy controls in the lurch. And I would propose that there be a collaborative group putting together patient with the syndrome and appropriate controls that are agreed upon, and that a neutral party take those individuals, draw multiple samples from those, and store them as a repository to then be distributed to the laboratories that are part of the working group or additional ones. Unless we start testing the same patients with different methodologies, we're not going to get anywhere. And, I really want to emphasize that to resolve this discrepancy between 0% and 80%, we all have to be testing the same samples. And I'd like to know, among the panel and the audience, what are the plans for that?
Well, let me just say about the blood working group, and I think that this is one of the goals of the clinical panel that you heard Graham talk about, is that through the clinical panel, we will be able to characterize some of those positive donors, or I should say patients. Now, the thing is that, we have we have relied very heavily on Judy, and we have her sample population. And I think that what we have to do is we have to make sure that we have a good cross-section. I agree that there's a lot of patients that come around the world, actually, to Judy's facility. But I think that we really need to see a geographic distribution of this. And I agree totally with you. I think one of the things that I heard over the last couple of days was the lack of a standard. And I think that that's something else that hopefully we will have as an outcome of the blood working group and some of the panels that we're trying to establish.
Yeah, I'd also like to address that. We saw at this meeting several posters, and we heard from four physicians, Dr. Cheney, Drs. Bell, we know Dr. Peterson, Dr. Komaroff on the Lowe study. These are experts at the diagnosis of, and they're diagnosing the same patients generally, and we saw the same percentage of positive patients in those. So those are patients geographically located, as you heard Dr. Cheney say, from around the world, from the northeastern United States in the case of the Hansen-Bell study. I know that Nancy Klimas gets a lot of patients from Florida. So we can begin to address that because there are clinicians that have have been identifying similar positivity rates. So we can pull positive samples from each of those and really begin to put together